In this video, we'll be solving a tricky equation from Oxford Math. The equation is sine x to the power of 8 plus cosine x to the power of 6 equals 1. Here, x is bigger than or equal to 0, less than 2 pi. We are going to solve this equation in two ways. So let's see the first method. So we're going to begin with the range of sine x. So sine x is bigger than or equal to negative 1, less than or equal to 1. Also, for cosine x, it's also bigger than or equal to negative 1, less than or equal to 1. So now let's consider the sine x squared. So then sine x squared is bigger than or equal to 0, then less than or equal to 1. Because here, in this equation, we have sine x to the power of 8. Then sine x to the power of 8, we can write as here sine x to the power of 8 is equal to sine x squared, then to the power of 4. So that's why the first, we're going to consider several cases based on sine x squared. So now let's see the first case. The first case, sine x squared equals 0. So then we have then sine x equals 0. Then cosine x equals positive negative 1. Then take these two cases, then take these two to the equation. That will make the equation true. So then let's solve these two equations. Then we have x equals 0 and x equals pi. Because given x is bigger than or equal to 0, less than 2 pi. That is the first two solutions. So now let's see the second case. Second case, that is a sine x squared equals 1. Okay, that's second case. Sine x squared equals 1. So then we have here just sine x equals positive negative 1, then cosine x equals 0. Again, bring these two cases then to the equation. Then make this equation true. Then solve these two. We have x equals pi over 2. Then x equals 3 pi over 2. So that's another two solutions. Okay, so now let's see the third case. Third case, just sine x squared bigger than 0, less than 1. So now let's see the third case. Sine x squared is bigger than 0, less than 1. From here, we also can get cosine x squared is also bigger than 0, then less than 1. So now let's consider the left-hand side of the equation. So that is sine x to the power of 8 plus cosine x to the power of 6. Then here we can write as just the sine x squared, then to the 4th, here cosine x squared, then to the 3rd. Okay, so now let's compare this term with sine x squared. Let's see which one is bigger. Because sine x squared is bigger than 0 but less than 1. So for a quantity, so bigger than 0, less than 1, then the higher the power, then the smaller the value. So that's why this term is less than sine x squared. Same thing here. So here cosine x squared is bigger than 0, less than 1. So now let's compare this one with cosine x squared. Again, so for the value is bigger than 0, less than 1, then the higher the power, then the smaller the value. So that's why this quantity is less than cosine x squared. So that's why then here is the sum. So here this part is less than this part. Then based on the trig identity, so this one equals 1. So what that means, so then we have here. So this is the left-hand side of the equation. So then here we have sine x to the power of 8 plus cosine x to the power of 6 less than 1. So that means for the equation, sine x to the power 8 plus cosine x to the power 6 equals 1, then has no solution for the third case. Okay, so then for the third case, this equation has no solution. So now let's combine the three cases. So then what are the solutions? That's the two solutions from the first case, two solutions from the second case, then no solutions in the third case. So now let's see. Let's combine the three cases together. Then the solutions of the equation are x equals 0, then pi over 2, then pi, then 3 pi over 2. So then they are the solutions of this trig equation. That is the first case. That's the first method. So we're done with the first method. So now let's see the second method. For the second method, we're going to define two new variables. So let's see here. So first, let's define u equals sine x. Then v equals cosine x. Because we have this identity, because cosine x squared equals 1 minus sine x squared, then we have the following. Because cosine is v, so that's why we have v squared equals, this is v, then equals 1 minus sine u, then minus u squared. Okay, so now we're going to use these three to solve our equation. Okay, so now let's see. This is a given equation. Sine x to the power 8 plus cosine x to the power 6 equals 1. Okay, let's do the substitution. So then this one is u to the 8th. Then this one, so that is a v to the power 6, then equals 1. Because v to the power 6, we can write as v squared, then to the 3rd. Then for v squared, we can use this one to replace it. That's why, then for the next step, then we have u to the power of 8, then plus here 1 minus u squared. 1 minus u squared, then to the 3rd, then equals 1. Then for this part, we're going to use this formula. So that is a minus b to the 3rd, then equals a to the 3rd, minus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared, then minus b to the 3rd. Okay, we're going to apply this formula to this part. Okay, so now let's continue. Then here we have u to the power 8, then here 1 minus 3 u squared plus 3 u to the 4th, then minus u to the power of 6. Then move 1 to the left hand side. Minus 1 then equals 0. So let's simplify. Then here u to the power 8, next one, minus u to the 6, then plus 3 u to the 4th, minus 3 u squared, then these two canceled, then equals 0. Let's take out the common factor u squared. Then here u to the power 6 minus u to the 4th plus 3u squared minus 3 then equals 0. Next, combine these two together, take out the common factor u to the fourth. And here u squared minus 1. Combine these two together, take out the common factor 3. So next, because inside the parentheses, they have a common factor u squared minus 1. So take out the common factor u squared minus 1. Then here, just u to the fourth plus 3 equals 0. So the product equals 0. So let each factor equals 0. So then here, we have the first one, u squared equals 0. Let the second one equals 0, solve for u, then we have u squared equals 1. Then the third one, let this part equals 0, then u to the fourth equals negative 3. Then for this one, so no real solution. Because u to the fourth cannot be negative. So for this one, there's no solution, no real solution. So now let's solve these two cases. Because at the beginning of this method, we said u equals sine x. So that's why let's see the first case. So then u squared equals 0. So that means sine x squared equals 0. So that means x equals 0 in the pi for x between 0 and bigger than or equal to 0, less than 2 pi. So that is the first two solutions. So now let's see the second case, u squared equals 1. Now let's see the second case, u squared equals 1. So then sine x squared equals 1. Then here, the sine x equals positive negative 1. Then we have x equals pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. So these are the another two solutions. So now let's combine them together. So then the solutions of the equations are here. X equals 0, pi over 2, then pi, then 3 pi over 2. There are four solutions for this trig equation.